Next, we're going to have the mayor of Oshkosh, Steve Cummings.
Thank you, Kurt. Thank you, Mary, for hosting this event and all of my colleagues that have traveled here today. So far, the city of Oshkosh has had to refund over $300,000 to only two Walgreens locations. So adding that to Appleton's million plus, the meter is running very fast in the state of Wisconsin for our homeowners. There's one thing I think that has been overlooked a bit in this is the cost all of us incur for providing municipal services. One area is police and fire protection. For two of our stores in the city, one is a Walmart and the other is a Fleet Farm, our police have responded to one call a day. So that's 365 times two stores, that's over 750. If you roll in the Menards we have, a Lowe's, we have a huge outlet mall, our police are responding to easily over 2,000 calls a year to these locations. They make a couple of calls to the dark stores. But yet these organizations feel that they should be assessed on a vacant building, yet they are demanding an inordinate amount of services from a community. And it's just going to grow and grow and grow. So I think it's critical. I have been to Madison twice to testify. I think it's critical that these bills get passed so we don't have to continue shifting the tax burden to the homeowner and the local small businesses in the state. So thank you, everyone. Kurt?
Thank you. Before I introduce or welcome to the podium our final speaker, who's going to be Representative David Steffen, I'd like to just take 1 minute, 1 second to explain this poster right here, because this really documents and it describes better than words can what we're talking about here. One of the bills that we're seeking passage would reverse a Wisconsin Supreme Court decision from 2008 that allows this type of division between assessed value and properties sold, the actual sale price of properties sold on the fair market. These are all recent examples within the last 2 years, 2016 and 2017. These are Walgreens or CVS stores that have convinced courts, based on this Supreme Court decision that we're seeking to overturn through legislation, that even though they sold for, in this case, $8.7 million on the market, their assessed valuation that the city is allowed to charge or value is $3.4 million. So this does not apply to any other properties in the state of Wisconsin, and clearly not homeowners. Nobody else gets this type of an advantage. We think it doesn't make sense. We think it's unfair, and that's why we're pushing for a reversal of the Walgreens decision from 2008. So with that, I'd like to introduce our final speaker, then we can open up to questions. Representative David Steffen from Village of Howard, who represents the 4th Assembly District. David?
Well, good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming. I think many of the examples have been provided as to why this is important, and I wanted to distill it a little bit for those who may be residents, regular homeowners out there, wondering, well, how does this impact me? Why does it matter? Imagine having a home, your neighbor, having a home worth $280,000, and then that next door neighbor has the ability to hire the highest and best paid attorneys in the land and able to get their valuation reduced to $100,000 in order to avoid paying their share of taxes. That's exactly what's happening with this specific strata within all of the communities around the state. This could quite possibly be the largest tax shift in state history from one group to another. It is completely unfair that the homeowners, residents, small business owners who do not have the ability to hire these attorneys who are almost entirely funded through this mechanism to bear the responsibility financially for this type of situation. I'm the co-author of one of the bills and co-sponsor of the other. I'm working with my colleagues in both the Assembly and Senate to get this bill to the floor in both houses, and we are very close. We are running out of time, though. We only have about 60 days left to get this done. Now, in terms of some of the politics in the state assembly, we have to have 50 Republican votes in order to have a bill come to the floor, not 50 total, 50 Republican votes. That's the standard. So one of the things that we're hoping to do is bring additional attention, awareness, and action by people who are seeing this today, reading this today, to be aware that they need to be contacting their legislators, making sure that they are on board and engaged on this issue, because again, this could be the largest shift in taxes from one party to another in state history. We have an opportunity, we are on the precipice of rectifying this error that occurred many years ago. So I'm hopeful that the people who are watching this, reading this, have an opportunity to join us, join these local elected officials who work so very hard to ensure fairness, equity, cost-effective delivery of government to every one of our residents. So thank you for being here today. Really appreciate your time, and I'm sure Kurt will turn you over for questions.
Yes, thanks, Representative Steffen. Yes, any questions for any of the folks who spoke, or anyone back here want to make any comments that?